Hi guys and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to identify the issue if your scooter doesn't have a spark. Your scooter won't start but you are not sure yet whether it's due to the spark problem, then stick around because I'm going to show you how to check that. And if you already confirmed that your scooter doesn't have a spark, then this video is also for you because I'm going to show how to narrow down the fault to a specific component. Therefore, we will be looking at the spark plug, the spark plug connector, the spark plug wire, the ignition coil, and the connection between the CDI and the alternator. Stay tuned, let's get started. First, we will need to remove the seat along with the helmet compartment. As always, we unscrew the bolts here and take the seat out. Additionally, if your scooter has a service clip, you can remove that too. We'll start by checking whether the scooter has a spark at all. To do this, I first disconnect the plug from the spark plug. The spark plug is then accessible through this opening here. The standard tool for Chinese four-stroke scooters is a 16mm spark plug wrench. Simply place it on the spark plug and unscrew it. Usually, once it's loosened, you can remove the ratchet and unscrew it by hand. But be careful not to drop the spark plug into the housing, because you'll need to remove all the plastic parts here to get it back. And here's the spark plug. Now, to test whether there is a spark, reconnect the spark plug to the connector and put the spark plug against any metal part. For example, I'll put it here on the cylinder head. And now you can start the engine either using the electric starter or kickstarter, but be careful if you have a metal connector instead of a plastic one like this one. Don't hold onto the spark plug connector in that case. And here we see the spark. This is what it should look like. If it looks the same for you, you don't need to watch this video. If not, stay on board and let's find the problem together. But before you leave, don't forget to hit that thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any further useful videos. However, if you don't have a spark here, we will need to change our point of view and go to the right side of the vehicle. There is a small detail here that many people are unaware of, but it's extremely important for the ignition spark. It's the position of the pickup located under the fan cover. For example, after replacing the alternator, the position of the pickup can be misaligned. Here we can see that the gap between the pickup and the plate of the flywheel is about 4mm. And this gap is already too large, so no spark can be generated here. Let's try starting the scooter. It doesn't start because there is no spark. Now, let's carefully move the pickup closer to the flywheel using a screwdriver. The gap is now about 2mm and let's try starting the scooter again. Now we have our spark there. So before moving on and checking the spark plug connector, make sure to check the pickup, otherwise the rest of the work might be in vain. If you check the position of the pickup but there is still no spark, the next thing we will need to do is to check whether there is an issue with the spark plug or the spark plug connector. To do this, on the most Chinese scooters, you can simply unscrew the connector from the cable. Now we can check whether there are copper veins coming from the cable. If not, you can simply cut off half a centimeter to a centimeter of the cable. And now we definitely can see the wire strands. So now we can check if the electrical impulse reaches this point. Repeat the same procedure we did with the spark plug, now without it. Hold the cable a few millimeters away from the grounded surface and start the engine. If there is a spark plug at this point, the problem is likely with the spark plug or the spark plug connector. In the most cases, one of those two components should be suppressed. Now, what exactly does it mean? It means that a spark plug or a spark plug connector, or both of them, include an integrated suppression feature that reduces electromagnetic interference. An unsuppressed ignition system generates electromagnetic waves strong enough to interfere with radios, communication system, or other sensitive electronics like CDI or a fuel injection system in your scooter. To avoid this, they usually use a resistor about 5k ohm, which is built into the spark plug or the spark plug connector. And this resistor reduces the intensity of high frequency electromagnetic waves. Since most of modern scooters use a lot of electronics, both parts are suppressed, which offers a maximum reduction of interference. And also the ignition systems are strong enough to work with both resistances. However, on older and weaker ignition systems, on older vehicles, this double suppression might cause problems because the ignition system isn't strong enough for that. So maybe recently you changed a spark plug or spark plug connector and didn't pay attention whether one of those is suppressed. So let's find out. The spark plug is easily checked. If it is suppressed, you will find an R in its name. For example, the most common spark plug for Chinese four-stroke scooters is the CR7HSA. This R here means that the spark plug is suppressed because there is also a C7HSA without an R, which means that this one doesn't have that built-in resistor. We can also check it with a multimeter. For that, you set the multimeter to 20k ohm and hold the both probes on both sides of the spark plug. One of the probes, I used the red one, should be connected to the small electrode on the inner side of the spark plug. And we can see here, this spark plug has no built-in resistor, so its resistance is 0 ohm. And this one has approximately 5k ohm resistor. As you see, the number can be slightly different, but it should be around 5k. And the same way, we can check the connector. Just connect the probes to the metal parts on both sides of the connector. This one already says on the package that there is a 5k ohm resistor. And if we check it with the multimeter, we also can see it. So at this point, if you only had a spark with a spark plug cable, but not with the spark plug connector and the spark plug, you can check your scooter's manual and see if these are the right components. And if you don't have a manual, I would recommend to use a black connector from NGK. This is not a sponsored recommendation, it's just based on my experience. And for the spark plug, you can just look up in the internet or try another one. But the only difference should be if there is or there isn't an R. The other letters and numbers should be the same. All right, now let's continue with the scenario that you didn't have a spark with just the cable. In this case, we will need to check the wire leading from the spark plug connector to the ignition coil. We can unscrew the wire just like we did with the spark plug connector. And on this side, you can also cut off half a centimeter of the wire to check the standards again. Place one probe on one end of the wire and the other one on the opposite end. Now you can see one on the multimeter. It means that there is no connection. It would also show a one if the other probe is connected, but the cable is broken. When both probes are connected, the resistance should drop to zero. That would indicate that the wire is fine. In my case, it's a cheap multimeter, so don't pay attention to that 0.01. You can also flex the wire to ensure that there are no breaks or cracks. If the resistance stays at 0 ohm, the wire is in good condition. The next component to check is the ignition coil. It's held in place by just a single bolt, so you can easily unscrew it. Here's how it looks like removed. The cable connects here. To test it, use your multimeter again, set to 20k ohm. Measure between the terminals and the output. The reading here should be around 3 ohms. And 0 ohms between both terminals. You could also test this while everything is still installed. But that assumes that the wire has no breaks and that the strands are making a proper contact. Testing the parts separately gives more accurate results. The values I'm sharing here are specific for Chinese four-stroke scooters. Other models may have different values. If the values here are correct, we can rule out an issue with the ignition coil. And next we will examine the wires running from the CDI to the ignition coil. And here's what the CDI looks like. Some of you might have all the pins occupied, including both wires in the 4-pin connector. In that case, the ground wire would be at the top. Let me show you differently. In that case, the ground wire is here at the top. On my scooter, there are only 3 pins occupied, so the ground is here at the bottom. Looking at the CDI this way, the wire to the ignition coil is on the top left corner of the 4-pin connector. Usually it's black-green wire. For this test, I'll set the multimeter to 2000 ohms and measure between the green ground cable and the ignition coil wire. First, disconnect the connectors and set the CDI aside. Now place the black probe on the ground and the red probe on the black-green wire. The reading here should be 0 ohms. Well, as I already said, it's a cheap multimeter, so it shows 0.01, but it should be a 0. If the values here are fine, we have checked the entire path from the spark plug to the CDI, and next we will test the path from the CDI to the alternator. We will start with measuring the resistance of the pickup wire to the ground. It's that component we moved with the screwdriver earlier. And here we should read about 120 to 300 ohms. Now leave the black probe on the ground wire and measure the red-black wire. This is the high voltage coil. The reading here should be between 200 and 1000 ohms. And that looks good. And finally, I'll check the black-yellow wire, which leads to the ignition switch. When the ignition is off, it should read 0 ohms, and when the ignition is on, it should read infinite ohms. I just turn the ignition on and off again. And everything is fine here. So if all the values match, then all the cables, all the resistances are fine and the fault lies within the CDI, which needs to be replaced. If the values don't match, you can inspect the cables for breaks, just like the spark plug cable. And if the readings from the alternator cables are incorrect, you can test the alternator separately. I'll link the video on that in the video description. That's it for now. I hope I could help you. If you enjoyed the video, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Feel free to subscribe to my channel for more videos. And with that, goodbye and safe travels.